Hello students, myself Hiral Patiar from SNPIT RC Homerak. Today we are going to learn data models. Okay, so what is data models? Database model defines the logical design and the structure of a database and defines how data will be stored, accessed and updated in database management system. Okay, so there are many kind of data models. First is entity relationship model, network model, relational model, object oriented model. In today's lecture, we are going to learn entity relationship model. Okay. So, entity relationship model, you can say ER modeling also, right? So, ER modeling is a graphical approach to a database design. It uses entity relationship to represent real world objects, right? So ER model employs three basic notations: entity set, relationship set and attributes. So basic concept of ER model that we have seen, that entity relationship set and attributes. So what is entity first? So it is the thing or object in the real world that is distinct from all other object. Okay, for example, person, place is an object. You can take any things as a entity, right? And entity is represented by a rectangle which contain the name of entity. Okay, the examples for the college database, examples of entities for the college database are students, professors, course, department, result, class, object, and it is represented by rectangle like this rectangle, and in the rectangle there is a name of entity like student. Entity sets. Okay, entity sets means it is a set or group of entities of the same type that share the same properties or attributes. For example, set of all persons who are customer of a given bank. Right, set of all the students studying in a college, set of all the professors working in a college. Now attributes. Attributes means it is a property or a details about an entity. Right, for example, there is a student entity. Right, so which are the property of students, or you can say how you will define the students, which are the details of the students. So there is a roll number, student name, branch, semester, address, mobile number, age, SPI, and many more, right? So that attribute is represented by oval containing the name of attribute, like a student is an entity, and the attributes for the students are roll number and name, and which is connected via link. Okay, you can say via line, and it shows that there is an entity named a student, and roll number and name are the attributes for the students, right? You can show these many attributes like this roll number and name. So there are many kind of attributes. First is single valued and multi value attributes. Second, simple and composite attribute. And third one is derived attribute. So single valued attribute. Single value. Name suggests the particular attribute has a single value, right? This attribute has a single value. For example, the lawn number. Lawn number attribute for the specific lawn entity refers to only one lawn number. Such attributes are said to be a single valued. Okay, and its symbol is oval, and in that particular attribute name. Okay. Second example, you can say that PAN number for particular college, for particular students, there is a single PAN number, right? So for two students, there is no same number that we can identify to particular students. Okay, so roll number is also said that a single valued attribute. Then multi value attribute. This attribute have multiple value. Multiple value means, for For example, an employee may have 0, 1 or several phone numbers. Okay, and it is defined as a double ellipse or oval. You can say double ellipse to define the represent the multi-value attributes. Okay. Simple attribute. Simple attributes are those which are not divided into subparts. Right? Means roll number. Roll number has simple single value, right? But roll number is not divided into another parts. Okay. See, next you can say like this, roll number is a simple attribute, right? It cannot divide it, it is not divided into subparts. But composite attribute, composite attribute means it is divided into subparts. Okay, for example, name. So for name, you have a first name, middle name, last name. So it is a subpart of your attribute name. Okay, but same way in address, you have a street, city, state, pin code. Okay, these are the subparts for attribute name. Attribute address. Okay, so name is your attribute and its subparts are last name, middle name and first name, and these all subparts are connected via line. You can say link. So these kind of attributes are known as composite attribute, which has subparts. Derived attribute. Okay, the value for this type of attribute can be derived from the values of other related attributes. For example, age. Okay, age can be calculated using the current date and the birth date. Right, so this kind of attributes like age, so we can write directly age also, but value for this age that we have to calculate it, right, that we have calculated from birth date and current date. So this kind of attribute is known as derived attribute, that we have derived the value for this particular attribute and it is defined as or represented as the dashed ellipse, right, like this. Next is relationship set. Okay, relationship. So there is the relation between two entities, okay, and it is connected via line. So relationship is an association or connection between several entities. It should be placed between two entities and a line connecting it to an entity. Relationship is represented by a diamond connecting relationship's name. Okay. Relationship is represented via diamond symbol containing relationship name. And a relationship set is a set of relationship of the same type. So student entity, book entity, right? So issue is your relationship which represented via diamond and containing the relationship name, that is issue, and connecting via line. Okay, so what it means, student issue the book, okay, from library. Okay, so student issue the book. So this is the issue is the relationship between a student entity and book entity. Okay, connectivity between these two entity. So this is your simple example of ER diagram. Okay, so ER diagram of the library management system. Right, see here the green color rectangle containing the name inside are the entities. Right, books, publisher, members are the entities, name of entities. This oval or you can say ellipse are known as attributes. Right, so book has a attribute book ID, author, title, price, available, right, availability in library for a particular book. So its value is yes or no. Price means any value. Okay, title means book of title, book ID. Right, book ID means there is a multiple books in our library. Okay, so for library, for identifying the book, there is a book ID, right? Okay, so author, which author has written that book, right? And publisher, publisher means which publisher has published particular book. Okay, so publish ID, publisher address, publisher name are the attributes for the publisher. And members, okay, members of the library, right? So it says member ID, it has a membership date when it issued, right? And expiry date, it means when membership should be expired. Member's name, member's address, member's type, which kind of member is there, right? So these are the attributes for the members. And these two, published by and borrowed by, are the relationship between these entities. Okay, so here borrowed by has also attributes, that at which date book is borrowed by member, on which date it has to return, right? And in issue type, right? Issue topic, issue method, right? So ER diagram for library system, and this indicates students and book, two entities only, right? These are the attributes, as you know, attributes for the students, attribute for the book, and this issue is a relationship between student and book. So this relationship between two entities only, so it contain only two entities, that's why it's known as binary relationship, right? And in this figure there are three entities: faculty, project and student, right? So these three entity, and between these three entities there is an one relationship, right? So relationship between three entities is called ternary relationship, right? See, faculty, project, student, three entities, it has a single relationship guide, that faculty guide the students about particular project. You can make the statement like this. Okay, so when three entities are connecting via single relationship, it known as ternary relationship. Okay, thank you.